And of course, joining me right now is Dr. James Daly of Southeast Lung Associates. Dr. Daly, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
So of course, we're talking about sleep apnea, and it's on everybody's minds these days. But for some of our viewers who may not be familiar with sleep apnea, because we know that a lot of folks aren't, tell us, what is sleep apnea?
Well, sleep apnea is a condition that occurs during sleep where an individual has obstruction to their breathing that causes their sleep to be disturbed. They may not know about this, but they'll recognize the next day that they'll awaken feeling fatigued.
Why do you feel like so many people, you know, go through years and years and years, and it's probably not a healthy thing, not seeking treatment for this? They just think this is the way it is.
Well, it's just people. You know, people learn to live with things. Think about it. If you're not breathing, you're choking, your oxygen level's decreasing, your body's being starved of oxygen, particularly your vital organs, your brain, your heart. This is occurring repeatedly during the night. That's tremendously stressful for the body. The body has to respond with a fight or flight reaction to restore your breathing. Doing this hundreds of times a night, that is sleep in reverse. That is stressful sleep, not restful sleep.
Is this something relatively new that we're seeing, Dr. Daly, as far as, I mean, this issue's been around for a very long time.
It's been around for years. We've been studying this for years. We've been treating this since as long as I've been a physician. I've been practicing sleep medicine for over 25 years.
Just as a fluke, my medical doctor said, I wasn't feeling real well, wasn't sleeping good, and he said, well, let's just do a sleep study on you and see what's going on. So I did a sleep study, and sure enough, they diagnosed me with sleep apnea. So they put me on a CPAP machine, which I hated. Had to sleep with it every single night. Early spring, I got a letter in the mail from Dr. Daly stating that they had a new process to cure sleep apnea. So I went in, and sure enough, I did qualify for it. They started my treatments in May, I believe in May. And once a month, for 6 months, I went into his office, and Dr. Silveria, who came down from Dublin, Georgia, they would deaden my tongue. And it wasn't a great fun process, but it only lasted a little while. They deadened my tongue, and then he went in with a radio frequency probe and actually injured the inside of my tongue. And so when it would heal, it would shrink.
It's called radio frequency base of tongue ablation. Ablation means destruction or reduction, like they do with cardiac ablation for treating cardiac arrhythmias. Mm-hmm. It's a technique using radio frequency waves, like a microwave.
Who's a good candidate?
The most ideal candidate are individuals who are thinner. We like a body mass index, you know, the weight to height ratio of 35 or less. The heavier you are, the less well this tends to work. The individual with the more mild to moderate sleep apnea works better. Mm-hmm. But we've treated many individuals with severe sleep apnea and had them completely resolve their sleep apnea as well. So there's some variability there.
Before you get to that particular part, though, in assessing the situation, and you have patients who come in and they actually sleep here. I mean, you have rooms that they look like spa rooms, like beautiful hotel rooms almost. You know, you think when you're going through or going to a doctor's office and you're expected to sleep, I can't even imagine. How in the world are you going to get to sleep?
We wanted a center particularly to make people comfortable because we recognize that. If you're going to do something, you want to do it well. You want folks to come in and feel that they are going to have a comfortable, secure experience as if they're going to be in a nice hotel. So we developed the rooms around that idea that they would be in a nice hotel-like environment.
Mm-hmm. What would you say to that person who's never taken that time to pick up the phone or call that physician and say, I mean, they just think this is a way of life. They're just sleeping, you know, or not sleeping, rather.
Well, sleep is essential. It's one of the most basic of our functions that are necessary for good health. Mm-hmm. If you're not sleeping good, you're not going to have the best of health. You're not going to feel your best. You're not going to function at your best. talk to your doctor.
Well, thank you so much for being a part of the Southern Scene. It's a pleasure, and I hope you'll invite us back in.
Well, glad to.
It's just a wonderful topic, and thanks for educating us.
Appreciate you being here.
If you'd like more information on Southeast Lung Associates and also Sleep Apnea Treatment Centers of America, all you have to do is go to the information you see on your screen. Here's the thing. If you're sitting on your couch and you're even thinking about you're one of those individuals that you're having issues and problems of sleeping, there's no reason to suffer. Now's the time to pick up the phone, check out that information you see right there on your screen.